Now, what I would like you to take a look at, we've already made the connection between a set of ordered pairs and a correspondence diagram, but we could take either the set of ordered pairs or the correspondence diagram and write those as a table of values, which I have listed here. The first column is your x values or your domain values, and the second column is your range values, which we represent by f of x, and sometimes you might see it as y, but that's the same thing. One's function notation, the f of x. And so we can see that the 0 map to negative 1, the 3 map to negative 2, 8 to negative 3, 0 to 1, 3 to 2, and 8 to 2. So if you were looking at a table of values, you should be able to determine whether that table of values is a function or not. And we would be able to see that this table of values is not a function because if we look at an input, let's call 0, it's being sent to two places. It's being sent to negative 1 and 1. In other words, there's two ordered pairs with the same x-coordinate. So that's how you can tell that your table of values is not a function. More particularly, there's two distinct ordered pairs. So in other words, two different ordered pairs. We have 0, negative 1, and 0, 1. And so those have the same x-coordinate, but they have different y-coordinates, and that's what makes that table of values not a function. Now let's go ahead and take any one of the representations we've seen thus far for the same relation and apply that to a graph. So I'm going to go ahead and look at our table of values just because typically we have a table of values and then we graph. And so we could see that we have the point 0, negative 1. So we stay here at 0 and then go down 1. The point 3, negative 2, we go right 3, down 2. The point 8, negative 3, we go right 8, down 3. The point 0, 1, we stay here at 0 and then go up to 1. The point 3, 2, go right 3, up 2. The point 8, 2, we go right 8, up 2. So that's plotting all of those points. Now what I want you to notice from our graph, we have the x value 0, and we can see that 0 has two points associated with it. It has the point 0, 1 and 0, negative 1. In other words, 0 is mapped to 1 and 0 is mapped to negative 1. And we know from our definition of a function that means that this relation is not a function. And the same would go for our x value of 3. It's getting sent two places as well. It's sent to 2 and it's also sent to negative 2. And again, that's problematic as far as this relation not being a function. And then the same for 8. It's sent to 2 and it's also sent to negative 3. And again, that would cause this relation to not be a function. For all three of those reasons, this relation is not a function. But what I want you to notice visually is we were not a function as a result of the fact that x value is mapped to two places. And what happens is we see that we have this vertical line here that intersects at least two points. And we have this vertical line that intersects at two points, and this vertical line that intersects at two points. In fact, if you're trying to determine whether a graph is a function, we can apply what's called the vertical line test. And what the vertical line test says is that you should take your graph and draw a vertical line anywhere on that graph. So anywhere you want to draw a vertical line, you draw a vertical line. So if I draw a vertical line here, notice that if you were to intersect the graph at two or more points, anytime you drew one of those vertical lines, then you would not be a function, which is the case in our example. And we can see that when we draw our vertical lines, that we hit at two points, so we are therefore not a function. However, if you had a graph where you drew a vertical line and you only hit at most one point, then we would call that graph a function, a representation of a function.